Welcome back. We're doing program 14. So today we are doing program 1, which is going to be lower body. So I switched it up. So again, we have 6 stations. I'm going to take you through all 6 stations. How you perform them through your circuit is entirely up to you. You don't have to go through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can jump around. It doesn't matter to me as long as you do all 6 exercises before you go on to your second round and then your third round. So a total of 3 rounds. What you want to do is try to move through these exercises as quickly as possible with the least amount of rest. However, if you need to rest, do so. Grab a drink of water, shake it out, whatever you have to do, and jump back in. So we're going to start out with station number 1, which is right here. It's going to be squat box jumps with dumbbells. So here's some 10-pound dumbbells, so I would say 10 to 15 pounds for the majority of you, and I'll show you this in 2 different ways. So first, this is a timed one, so your timer is right up there. You're going to start out this week with 30 seconds. So when you're ready, press your time, and then basically you're doing exactly what I say, squat box jumps. So you're starting here, you're going down into a squat, then you're going to go over, squat, back, squat, over, squat. So basically into a box, your 4 corners. So turning it sideways so you can see my form a little bit better. What I want to see from you is as you squat down, your bottom, your butt, your glutes, they go back. Your chest does not bow forward, it stays up. Your knees are in line with your ankles. So here, jump to the side, jump back, jump. Okay, so again, 30 seconds this week. We'll be doing the back one. And number 2 is over here. It's going to be a one-legged squat with our dumbbells. So grab a heavy pair of dumbbells. So again, 10 to 15 pounds. And for this one, don't feel that you have to balance on one foot, but try to. So this is going to really engage our stability muscles. Also, our ankle joints, they're going to be definitely getting some extra work. So what I want, nice tight core, bringing these in front as we go down. Slide that foot back into, watch, into that squat, and then come up, and then back, and then up. If you need to put your foot down, go ahead, down, and up, and down, and up. So again, what you want to keep in mind is when you're coming down, so look at yourself in the mirror. You want to make sure that knee is not checking too much forward. Again, when we're doing a squat, we're pushing our booties back. So down, and then up. Down, and up. Again, balance, tap your toe. So you're going to do 12 on one leg and 12 on the other. Again, like I said, when you're going down, don't be afraid to tap your foot down. But remember not to bow too much forward because you really want to engage the glutes, the hamstring, and of course your quads. So number 3, we're going to bring it down to the floor. We're going to use some resistance bands in this one. So this one's going to be tricky, and it's just going to be the setup. Make sure your resistance band are even. I want you to then flip over, bringing them on each side. From here, we're going to bring our leg up, and we're going to come in and release. So hamstring curl up, keep that foot flexed, and out. Up and out. So you want to keep that leg nice and high, so you're really engaging that hamstring, your quad, your calves, and keeping that foot flexed. Okay? That's all there is to that one. We're going to do 18, 18, then your next set, you're going to go down to 15, and your third round, you'll go down to 12. So I can get out of this, and then we will move to station 4, which is right over here. This one is a timed one as well, so this week we are starting at 30 seconds. Grab a heavy set of dumbbells. So again, for most of us, that'd be 10 or 15 pounds. 20 pounds, certainly are able to use the other ones. If you can, challenge yourself, push yourself. That's how you're going to get stronger. So don't just get comfortable. Don't use the same weights all the time. We want to build strength. We need to challenge ourselves. Okay, so this one, holding them simply in our hands, reverse lunge, down 90 degrees with the back, 90 degrees with the front, coming up and kick. Reverse, down, push off that forward foot and kick. So when I'm doing this, you notice it's slow and controlled. I'm pulling that heel, really pushing it up, and then coming down. Up, heel, back. So I'm bringing my foot up where my heel is pushing forward and coming down. Okay, so we're doing 30 seconds each leg. So timed, so nice and slow and controlled. It's not about the reps. It's about getting a nice, deep lunge, pushing off that forward foot, digging that heel in, and bringing that heel up. So down, push. Down, push. And then opposite leg. So number 5, going back down onto the floor, using our resistance bands for the second time. Again, same sort of setup. Over top and in between, making sure your bands are nice and even. You're going to flip over onto your side. You're going to be in a straight line. You're going to pull up on those bands. Nice tight core. And just driving that leg up, pulling that band, feeling that resistance. Flexed foot, up. Little soft bend in the knee, down, up, down. You can see this is all in the hip flexor. You can see when I'm pulling it, I'm shaking, I'm really using that resistance. I'm really going to feel it here, and that's what we want. So nice straight line. So this one, obviously we're going to do both sides. This one, we're going to do 18 on each leg. First round, second round will be 15, and third round will be 12. So then, our last one is number 6 right here. And this one, it's kind of a dual. There's a couple different ways we can do this one. So it's a lunge to squat diagonal. So for most of us, we're going to start in a squat down, and when we come up, we're crossing over. Lunge, squat, lunge, squat, lunge, squat, lunge. And I want that momentum flowing. So to take it up a notch and to challenge yourself, even try this to start and then bring it down to a walking, squat, hop, squat, hop, squat, lunge. So that would be bringing it up. It's going to get your heart rate up. And you're getting a little plyo in there. So you're really going to activate those quads, glutes, hamstrings. So that's station 1 through 6. That is, for this one, we're going to do 18. First round, that's per leg. So 18, 15, and then 12. So I will be asking a lot from you guys, this one. Other than that, if you have any questions, reach out to me. You have the option of having me here twice a week with you, even if it's for 15 minutes, even if it's for one round, just to see your form, to tweak it, to make sure you're doing it right. That's what I'm here for. Please use me if you need me. Remember, when you come in, you want to do a quick warm-up, 5 minutes, get the blood moving, get the oxygen flowing, get the muscles lubed up, and when you're done, please remember to do your stretching. Stretching is just as important as your warm-up. We're lengthening those muscles. We're increasing our flexibility. We're cooling them down. So let's make sure that, you know, we do our cool down, we do our warm up, and we get in here, we get this workout done as quickly and safely as possible. Push yourself, and I will see you for the core workout. See ya!